In the last class, we learned delta star and star delta transformation. And in this class, we shall discuss some questions. This is the first question. This resistance is 20 ohm. This resistance is 50 ohm. This resistance is given as 30 ohm. This resistance is of 5 ohm. And finally, this resistance is 24 ohm. This circuit contains two deltas. This one is a delta and this one is another delta. That's why this circuit can't be solved by using our series and parallel circuit rules. So all we have to do is we have to transform one of these two delta into its star equivalent. So in this question, I must try to convert this delta into its star equivalent. Before that, let me name those points. This point is A. This point is B. This is our C. And this is D. And in this question, we shall transform A, B, D delta to its star equivalent. Let's assume a midpoint here. This resistance is connected to point D. So this is RD. Likewise, this resistance is connected to point A. That's why I can say this is RA. And this is RB as it is connected to point B. Here we have to calculate the values of RA, RB and RD. In the previous class, we have already said we need to remember one formula, that is product of two adjacent arms divided by the sum of all three arms of the delta. So while calculating RB, the two adjacent arms are 20 ohm and 30 ohm. So RB is equal to 20 ohm into 30 ohm divided by the sum of all three resistances of the delta. Again, RD is equal to the product of two adjacent arms, these are 50 ohm into 30 ohm divided by the sum of all three resistances of the delta. The same procedure to find RA. RA is equal to the two adjacent arms are 20 ohm and 50 ohm. That's why 20 ohm into 50 ohm divided by the sum of all three resistances of the delta. This is equal to 6 ohm. Which is equal to 10 ohm. And we got 15 ohm. So now I can replace the delta. So now you can solve the circuit by using series and parallel circuit rules to find the equivalent resistance. So let me implement the question here. This resistance is of 20 ohm. According to the question, this is 50 ohm. This resistance is 30 ohm. This is 24 ohm. And this resistance is 5 ohm. So friends, let's connect the circuit according to the question. Here I am taking a DC source whose magnitude is 220 volt. Now I simply connect the circuit.
Now let's check. The circuit draws 10 ampere current from the source. Now let's rearrange it with the star equivalent. This resistance is RA, whose magnitude is 10 ohm. Then this is RB. We have already found RB is equal to 6 ohm. And this is RD, which is equal to 15 ohm. Now let's connect the circuit. In this arrangement, the circuit draws the same amount of current, that is 10 ampere, from the source. That's why I can say the equivalent resistance of the circuit remains same. This is the second question. In this question, a galvanometer is connected here. Its internal resistance is given as 40 ohm. This resistance is of 10 ohm. This is 20 ohm. This resistance is 15 ohm. This resistance is given as 30 ohm. There are two deltas in this electrical network. To solve this question, we need to transform one of the two deltas into star. This point is A. Let's say this point is B. This point is C. And this point is D. Now I shall transform the first delta into star. Let's assume this is the midpoint and a resistance is connected to point B. So this is RB. Likewise, here is a resistance that is connected to point A. So this resistance is RA. Here also another resistance that is connected to point D. So this resistance is RD. Let's find RA. RA is equal to the product of two adjacent arms. Those are 10 ohm and 20 ohm. So RA is equal to 10 ohm into 20 ohm divided by the sum of all three resistances of the delta. Those are 10 ohm, 20 ohm and 40 ohm. That is equal to 2.86 ohm. RB is equal to, this resistance is RB and its two adjacent arms are 10 ohm and 40 ohm. So product of two adjacent arms, 10 ohm into 40 ohm divided by the sum of all three resistances of the delta. RB is equal to 5.72 ohm. RD is equal to, here is the resistance RD, its two adjacent arms are 20 ohm and 40 ohm. So product of two adjacent arms divided by the sum of all three resistances of the delta, 10 ohm, 20 ohm, 40 ohm. Which is equal to 11.4 ohm. So friends, now we have already found the all three resistances of the star. That's why now we can replace the delta. RA is equal to 2.86 ohm, RD is equal to 11.4 ohm and RB is equal to 5.72 ohm. Now by using series and parallel circuit rules, you can easily solve this circuit. According to the question, I need 5 resistances. This one is 10 ohm. This resistance is 20 ohm. This resistance is 30 ohm. This resistance is 15 ohm. Now I need one more resistance to represent the galvanometer whose resistance is 40 ohm. I need one voltage source whose magnitude is, let's say, 100 volt. So let's connect. Look, this circuit draws 5.54 ampere from the source. And now I shall replace the first delta by its star equivalent. This resistor is RA, and we already have found RA is equal to 2.86 ohm. Okay, this is RB, and RB is equal to 5.72 ohm. Likewise, this is RD, and we have found RD is equal to 11.4 ohm. Okay, so let's connect. Now look, so friends, what I did, I simply replaced the first delta by its star equivalent, and the result is in front of you. In the both cases, the circuit draws 5.54 ampere current from the source. That means in each arrangement, the circuit has its equivalent resistance same.